before the Joint Select Committee as also in the Lok Sabha. Very strong arguments were advanced and it was said that something more should be done than what had been proposed at present in the case of linguistic minorities. This they wanted done by the insertion of a particular provision in the Constitution. It would be clear to honorable members when the Constitution 9th Amendment Bill is taken into consideration. The State's Reorganization Commission have also dealt with this question and have suggested that the minorities should not be allowed to develop a separatist tendency. They should not ask for a state within a state or something else incorporatable with their citizenship of that particular state. Still, it is essential, especially where there are linguistic minorities, that some proper safeguards should be evolved. For that purpose, certain provisions have to be included in the Constitution. Now, some members of the Joint Select Committee in particular were not happy. They desired that something more should be done, and in particular they were anxious that these safeguards should be statutorily recognized, that is, either they should be placed in the state's reorganization bill itself or in the Constitution. That question was considered by the Home Ministry, and we have already sent out to the various state governments a circular, a copy of which was placed before the Joint Select Committee. This circular has been published along with the report of the Joint Select Committee. In that, honorable members will find that certain safeguards have been suggested regarding middle or high schools, regarding concessions in respect of administrative matters, etc. It was suggested that the governor ought to have some powers of making inquiries into these matters. The governor also will be making inquiries in the light of the amendment that has been proposed in the Constitution 9th Amendment Bill. It was further contended that it would not be sufficient unless we have got statutory safeguards. So far as these statutory safeguards are concerned, it was considered that it would not be advisable in the interest of the linguistic minorities themselves to have these safeguards. What is most important is that though certain rights have to be safeguarded to the minorities, they have to develop a sense of oneness and harmony with the rest of the population, and the rest of the population also should not believe that these people have got separatist tendencies. If certain statutory safeguards were introduced, it was felt that they would lead rather to the worsening of the good relations between the linguistic minorities and others than to any improvement. Therefore, all that could be done was to send out a circular to the state governments pointing out broadly the main features of such safeguards with the desire that they should protect or safeguard the interests of the minorities to the extent possible, subject to the reservations that I have already pointed out. It was also suggested that just as we have in the case of the scheduled castes and the tribes, a commissioner appointed by the government who goes to the various states, finds out the position and then makes a recommendation or a report which is considered by the government of India, the state governments and others. There ought to be a separate officer for the purpose of finding out the position so far as the linguistic minorities are concerned. On behalf of government, an assurance was given that this question would be duly considered by the government of India, and if they find that the appointment of such an officer would be useful to the interest of the linguistic minorities, then such an officer would be appointed. However, I would point out that so far as statutory guarantees are concerned, I would desire that these guarantees should not be insisted upon, because after all, we have to develop a sense of oneness. In any state and every state, there are bound to be linguistic minorities, and their attempt ought to be to completely harmonize themselves with the majority community. The majority community has also to be generous so far as the legitimate rights of these people are concerned. So, this process of mental approach towards each other would perhaps be halted or at least adversely affected if such guarantees are given. We would then think more and more of the guarantees and of the enforcement of these guarantees through the courts of law or otherwise. This will result in the relations getting impaired and will be harmful to the ultimate interest of the nation. This is what might be found to a certain extent in the state's reorganization bill. This question will be considered at a greater length when the Constitution 9th Amendment Bill comes before the House for consideration. So far as the services are concerned, some attempts have been made to lay down the general principles. There are only two All India services, namely the IAS and the IPS. These are the only two All India services, and what has been decided is that there would be fresh cadres so far as the new states are concerned, and officers would be transferred from one cadre to another after taking all the relevant circumstances into account, the requirements of the states and also the work that these officers had carried on. That process would be completed after the work is started. The work had to go on and the process would be complete as early as possible. So far as the state services are concerned, certain principles have been laid down. One such principle is that in the case of a whole state merging with another bigger state, all the officers at various levels will be carried over into that state. The difficulty arises when you have to deal with the question of the transfer of certain portions of a territory to one state and another portion to other states, as in the case of Andhra Pradesh and as in the case of Maharashtra.